People smuggling, drug importation and illegal fishing vessels. These are just some of the threats to Australia's vast and sparsely populated northern coastline. The Army is specifically recruiting Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander soldiers who know the area best to be the country's first line of defence.
They call themselves the eyes and the ears of the North. And the soldiers of 51st Battalion, based in Townsville, have unique skills like no other. ...30-year-old Edmund Laser is a veteran with 9 years of experience.
We're pretty connected to the land where I come from. In the Army, we contribute a lot with cultural skills. For instance, survival tactics.
For these soldiers, traditional skills and instincts matched with army training is proving a successful combination.
Having been in several successful missions, people smuggling, drug smuggling, illegal fishing up in my waters, up in the Torres Straits, well, for me, it's a pretty big step in contributing to the community, the safety of the community.
When it comes to the recruitment rates of Indigenous and Torres Strait Islander Army reservists, the 51st Battalion Far North Queensland Regiment is on target at around 40%, which is much higher than usual. In many remote and regional centres, particularly Indigenous communities, opportunities to gain meaningful employment can often be hard to find.
We do recruiting a little bit different to the rest of the Army. We go to community, we engage with the elders, community leaders, and we try to engage with the entire community to have soldiers or candidates who can be recruited from community.
The absence of a Year 10 education and formal ID documents are commonplace and adds further barriers to employment. Regional Force soldiers are now offered a special assistance program to overcome these obstacles.
While the 51st Far North Queensland trains its recruits to be combat ready, like you can hear behind me, or for surveillance, it aims to treat its recruits in a way that makes them future leaders once they return to their communities.
For me, it's all about being a role model for, not only for my kids, but for my community and every community and on Cape York or in Australia. Because most of the stuff that I've been doing is pretty much wanting to better myself, to better my community, to better my life, the challenges that comes with it.
Ryan Little, SBS World News.